each little bird.
I mean, we're all conditioned to just assume, it's just an assumption that you're going to get married and have kids, and it's never like if, it's kind of a when, you know? And especially girls, like we all grew up and, or growing up, we all played it out, and we played these little games with like, you remember like MASH? And,
oh yeah.
Like you would list out like all your little like boyfriends or guys that you had crushes on, and then you like,
what kind of house you live in?
Yeah, like what kind of house, what car, your job.
Where'd you go for your honeymoon?
Yeah, and the match was like mansion, apartment, shack, house.
We like drew it as a swirl, and then like you'd say, tell me where to stop, and then you'd count the lines down.
And then you'd go through and like mark them out till you had all your answers.
Yeah.
And that was your life. And like, I guess it all ends with marriage and kids, like.
Because that's what the game is based on.
Yeah, so then the rest is just like happily ever after.
I have met someone.
He was one of my guys in MASH. He was always one of them.
Well, he's tall and handsome and so romantic.
Like, he was older than me, and he was in the ensemble, which is what everyone at the theater camp, like, aspired to be in. And so all the kids that were, like, in the ensemble were, like, the cool kids, and he was a cool kid. And so when he talked to me, I was like, oh, this is special. Actually, I had a crush on him from, like, the second grade on.
He takes me in his arms, and then...
Yeah, he always had a girlfriend, though.
I wake up.
We actually had this old note I wrote to Kristen that we got framed and had it at our reception. And it was like, dear Kristen, these are my boyfriends. And Brandon was like only number 5.
Why, it's my dream prince.
And he's an actor and a singer and a musician and, you know, very confident, very talented. No, yeah, he's very much the hand. Everyone said I look like a princess.
It's Aurora! She's here! And Philip!
Oh, the happy couple. Well, the photographer was orchestrating the pictures. See, there's the awkward kiss. I was like, I hate PDA. I can't believe I have to kiss him in front of everyone I know.
Oh, that's cute. Mm-hmm. You guys look like you actually love each other a lot there. And like you're excited for this ceremony together.
Yeah.
And life to begin.
What is on your dress? He dropped chocolate on my dress and didn't even notice.
Of course he did.
Yeah, of course he did. No, the first time the photographer wasn't ready, so I had to take it back and throw it again.
That's a long pain to throw.
I know.
And you didn't wear a veil.
No, I thought that was kind of traditional.
I just love happy endings.
The rest of your life is such a long time. Like, you're a growing, changing person, and how are you going to say that you want to be with this person the rest of your life when you don't even know what you're going to be doing 10 years from now? I mean, I grew up. I was 19, you know? Like, I changed my beliefs because I got away from, like, my home and my church and, you know, like, started thinking about things away from all that influence and, I guess, just got to know myself better and got to know him better and, I can't imagine anyone worse for me and I don't know how I could have made such a bad decision. I thought I was so mature.
It's just that you're a
stranger?
He wants to be the center of attention at all times, and he thinks he's doing everyone a favor if he's making jokes all the time because he's making sure that they're having a good time. And really, people think it's annoying. And his jokes aren't even that funny after a while. It's like, I've heard them all.
No.
Like, when we would go out to parties with his friends, I was always uncomfortable, and he always enjoyed playing the role of, like, the married couple, you know? I'm never gonna be single again. I'll always be divorced. Like, even in 30 years, if I haven't gotten remarried, I'll still be like, you know, when you check the boxes, it's like single, and then a separate box is like divorced. Like, you never go back to single, you know? Okay, so if you want to get divorced in New York, you have to have grounds. Like, you have to have a reason. And there's this, like, really short list of reasons why you can get divorced. But they don't ask you for a reason when you get married. People just view you as different once you've been married. Like, I don't know. Like, I guess tainted a little bit. Like, there's this perception of, in the whole, like, title change and going from, like, Miss to Mrs. And, like, you're never really a miss again.
Still, with this perfect finale, the cheers in the valley, who wouldn't be happier? So, I couldn't be happier, because happy is what happens when all isn't it?